Now that we have seen how delta debugging works on paper, we should actually go and implement it as a Python program. Here we start implementing the delta debugging function. Formally, this is the delta debugging algorithm for minimizing, so we call it ddmin for delta debugging minimizing. And it takes an input, and it takes a string as a parameter. This is the string to be simplified. We could make ddmin even more generic by also passing the test function as a parameter. Then we could use it for arbitrary tests in arbitrary context. For this exercise, however, we'll simply use the hardwired testing function, which we already have seen. And we start with the assertion that, again, testing the entire input should fail. We have a variable n, which sets the granularity. As described before, this is initially 2. We now set up a while loop, which loops while the input still has at least 2 characters. If it has 1 character, then there's nothing left to simplify. We define the length of the individual subset by simply dividing the length of the entire input by our current granularity. And we have a loop guard in here. This variable will be set as soon as some test fails. The variable start is a cursor over the input, which tells us where to start chopping away individual parts of the input. And here precisely, we do the chopping. Start tells us where to start chopping away things. That is, everything up to start should be included in our test. Then, beginning from start, plus the length of a subset, we also want this to be included in our testing input. What's missing in here, of course, is a string starting from start with the length subset length. This is what we test, and we check whether the result is fail. That is, if after chopping away a subset, the test fails, well, what do we do then? We set our input to the complement. That is, we keep on working with a now simplified string. We decrease the granularity by 1, but don't let it fall below 2. And we set the variable sumComplement is failing to true, because we need this to step out of this loop, which we do right away. If the test has not failed, then we have to proceed to the next subset, which we get by simply increasing our start cursor, which now points to the beginning of the next subset. And this is something we do until we have reached the end of our string. So now, at this point, we have gone through all the subsets, and either some complement has failed, then this variable is true. So far, so good. We simply keep on working with these new reduced, simplified inputs and a decreased granularity. However, if all of these tests pass, what should we do? Remember the third step in the delta debugging algorithm. We now need to increase the granularity, but must make sure it doesn't get over the length of the total string. And I will leave it to you as a programming exercise to complete this code. Over to you.